Hello everyone, welcome to the Banking and Financial Services class. I'm Impa Belipa, Associate Professor, Department of MBA, Maharaja Institute of Technology, Mysore. We are in Unit 4 and in the previous classes, we have done few problems related to leasing. And in today's class, we'll be doing the problem pertaining to hire purchase. Okay, so in this hire purchase problem, first we'll solve simple problem. Actually, the simple problem is given in the question paper. So initially, we'll start with the question paper problem. And then we'll see what variety problem it comes. Majorly, they give the leasing problem for the exam. Rarely, they ask for hire purchase problem. So let's see what is given in the question paper. So the question paper is December 2016, Jan 2017, 14 scheme and case study. I'll just write here. December 2016, Jan 2017, 14 scheme case study. So this is the problem which we are solving now. Okay, I'll read out the problem for you. There are two questions in this. So both are based on hire purchase system. So I'll read out the question. On 1st April 2015, a manufacturing company buys on hire purchase system a machinery for 60,000 rupees payable in 3 equal annual installments combining principal and interest. The rate of interest was 5% per annum. Calculate the amount of cash price and interest. So what is the given? The given, they have given three numericals. That is, first one is the machinery on hire purchase. It is 60,000. Okay, and installment, they have said 3 equal installments. And interest, they have given us 5%. So this is the question and they've said calculate the cash price and interest. So we have to calculate the cash price and interest. In order to calculate the cash price and interest based on this information, actually we do hire rentals is equal to cash price divided by present value interest factor interest for number of years. So what we are going to write? We are going to write the formula cash price divided by present value interest factor annuity at a certain interest rate and for number of years. So here what we are going to do, we can change the formula according to the information which is given. So what I'll do is we are going to find out the cash price. We know the hire rentals, but we don't know the cash price. So we are going to find the cash price. So I'll reverse the formula. Cash price is equal to hire rentals. Hire rentals into present value interest factor annuity at a certain percentage of interest and number of years. As we have already converted the formula, here I'll write the number of years and write the number of the interest rate. They have given 5% and 3 equal installments. So for 5% for 3 we are going to check the value. So I have the table. So either you can refer the table or you can directly calculate, add and then put the numericals. So hire rentals, they have said 60,000, but in that 60,000, they have said 3 equal installments. So it becomes 20, 20, 20. Okay. So I write here 20,000 into present value interest factor annuity table. The value is 2.7232. 2.7232. Okay, 7232. Either you can see this and write or table, or else you can just calculate. So let's multiply this So 20,000 into 2.7232. That is 54,464. So we have already got the cash prize. The cash prize is 54,464. They have asked two. One is the cash prize. This is the first one. And second one they have asked is interest. So we need to calculate the interest, and calculating interest is very easy. The formula for this is higher price minus cash price. So higher price minus cash price. So here higher price is what 20,000 is there. That is directly we can put 60,000, or else your 20,000 into 3 you can do anyhow. You can write the answer minus the cash price is just now which we have calculated, which is 54,464. So your answer is 5,536. So 5,536. So this is the answer for the first question in the question paper. Okay. I'll just rub this. Now let's see the second question, what they have asked. So I'll read out the question for you. A Limited purchased a machine from B Limited on higher purchase basis on the following terms. So down payment, they have said it is 20%. Three installments of rupees 2 lakh each. So installment is 3 and it is of 2 lakhs each at the end of the first year. So they have a combination of first year, third year and sixth year. So three installments of 2 lakh at the end of first year, third year and sixth year. And interest is 10% per annum. Given these information, you are required to compute the cash price of the machine. So you need to calculate the cash price of the machine. The difference between the previous problem and this problem is their down payment was not there and this down payment is given, and there it was continuous. Here it is split by split, that is first year, third year and sixth year. If in this case the problem is given, how do you solve it? So what you need to do is we need to take the cash price as X. So I'll write, let the, this is the second question, it is two, I guess. Yeah, it is the second question in the question paper. Let the cash price be X. So let the cash price be X. Now we don't know what is the cash price, and they have said 20% of it is being given for down payment. So we need to calculate from there. If 20% is given for the down payment, what is left? 80% is left. 80% of X, and 80% of X should be divided for 3 equal installments. That is 1, 6, 1, 3 and 6. Okay, so 80% of X is equal to present value of 3 installments of 2 lakh. 3 installments of 2 lakh rupees, of 2 lakh rupees, that is the 20% down payment. Okay, so to put this in a simplest way, so I'll write 80%, I'll write 0.8x, okay, 2 lakh divided by 1 plus 1 plus 0.1, that is nothing but 10%. Okay, again I need to include two more installments. 2 lakh divided by 1 plus 0.1 for third year. Okay, then 2 lakh divided by 1 plus 0.1 for the sixth year. Okay, like this, 3 installments I have written for 1, 3 and 6. So, I will take the common ones out. So, common one is 2 lakh. I have taken the 2 lakh out. And now, what I will do is, here I will be simplifying it continuously, putting the common ones out. Okay, so I will write 1 divided by 1.1. Okay, this is for the first one. 1 divided, I have taken the common one out. So, 1 divided by 1.1 plus 1 divided by 1.1. The same, but for 3 years plus 1 divided by 1.1. for 6 years. Okay, now I already have the table. So I'll look into the table for the values, or else you can do the calculation. If you want, you can directly put 1 divided by 1.1, you get 0.09. So I'll write here the value 0.909. 0.909. Okay, plus either you can do that continuously and do it for the third year, or else you can look into the table value and write it from the table value. And the table value for this is 0.751 for 3 years, and the table value for 6 years is 0.564. Okay, so I have the table value, I have already written it. Now, what I'll do is add all these table values. So, what are the table values? 0.909 plus 0.751 plus 0.564. So, you get 2.224. So, 2.224. So, this value I will multiply with this 2 lakh, I get 4,44,800. So, I have got 4,44,800, and this will be carried as usual. And from here onwards, when 0.8 comes this side, that becomes divide. So, x is equal to 4,44,800 divided by 0.8. Okay. So, divided by 0.8, and your answer is 5,56,000. Okay. 5,56,000. We'll just cross verify once. 4,44,800, right? No, 4,44,800 divided by 0.8. Yeah, 5,56,000. So 5,56,000 is your answer of X. That is the cash price. Is this clear? Any doubt on this? Understood. Okay, let's move to a similar problem, which is basic. If you just learn one problem, you can easily do the rest of the problems. Okay, so I'll just clear out. This is not the next problem which I'm doing is not a question paper problem. Only once the higher purchase problem was asked, so which we have solved. Okay, so we'll do another problem which is related to this type, but basic ones and easily understand them. Probably you'll remember your degree days where you were doing such kind of problem. So this is not an question paper problem. Let's see. I'll just read out the problem and write the given and then tell you how to solve it. Okay. So first they have said, I'll read out the problem. On 1st April 2012, Mr. Ram purchased from Mrs. Yuva and Company one motor truck under hire purchase system. Rupees 5,000 being paid on delivery, that is down payment. Okay, paid on delivery is what you paid, we call it as down payment. So, down payment is 5,000 rupees and the balance in 5 annual installments. So, installment is 5 of rupees 7,500 payable each at the end of the year. So, it is 7,500 is the installment amount. The cash price of the truck is 37. So, cash price of the truck is 37,500 rupees is the cash price of the truck. And vendor charges interest at the rate of 5% per annum. So, interest rate is 5%. Interest rate is 5%. And on yearly balances, find out the amount of principal and interest included in each installment. So, you need to find out the principal and interest included in each installment. So, I have written the given for you all. First is down payment. That is 5,000 and installments, 5 equal installments. Interest is 7,500 and cash price is 37,500. Interest is 5%. You need to calculate the principal and the interest. Okay, let's get going. So, first I will write calculation of principal and interest. Okay. Calculation of interest and principal. Okay, I could have reversed it, but it's okay, no problem. Okay, so calculation of interest and principal. So what I write the column is here. I'll write particulars. Here I'll write particulars, and after particulars, I'll write cash price. So, here I'll write the cash price. Then based on that installments, I'll write installments. So, installments. Installments are divided into 3 sets. Principal, interest and total. Principal, interest and total. Okay. So, let's start. They've given the cash price. Okay, so either you can write directly or else in the particulars we'll write and write. So I'll write cash price. So cash price is given in the problem, which is 37,500. Okay, then from that we are going to deduct the down payment. So either you can write the down payment or you can say paid in advance. Okay, so I'll write paid at the time of down delivery. Paid at delivery or nothing but the down payment. It is 5,000 rupees. So 5,000 rupees. So we need our calculator. Okay, for this I don't want 32,500. Okay, and here when you write the down payment, the whole amount goes to the principal because there is no interest charged yet. Okay, so I may need some more space. So after this, I'll be erasing. So then from this, after you get 32,000, your first installment starts. Okay, so I'll write first installment. Okay, from the first installment, how much is the first installment? First installment is 7,500. So for certain calculation purpose, I'll just put like this 7,500. From that, I'm going to put the interest rate. So interest rate, which is calculated at interest is at 5%, okay, on 32,500. So I'll write interest interest on 32,500 at 5%. So I'll need to calculate first 5% on 32,500. You get 1,625, and the remaining is 5,875. See, this is the total amount which he is going to pay for the first installment, out of which I have calculated interest of 5%, that is 1,625, that is the interest amount, and remaining will go to the principal. Okay. So again, if I want to calculate the interest, I have to calculate on which amount? I have to calculate on 26,625. Is this clear? Let's go to the second installment. So second installment I can complete here. So I'll write second installment. Okay, so second installment is 7,500 again, for which I have to deduct interest on this value, that is 26,625 at 5%. So on this, if I have to calculate 5%, I got 1,331. Okay, 1,331, this is the interest, and if I have to deduct that, I get 6,169. So I'll just put up all the values. So total amount of second installment is 7,500 and interest is 1,331, and the balance is 6,169. The same amount I'm going to write here and find out what is the balance. 26,625 minus 6,169. You get 20,456. Okay, you get 20,456. Next, again, we'll write third installment. I'll write here itself. Third installment, 7,500 minus interest on this value we have to put, 20,456 at 5%. So let me calculate 5% on this. I get 1,023. Okay, so 1,023 minus 7,500, you get 6,477. So 6,477. Now I'll write all the amount of third installment. 7,500. I've written total. Interest is 1,023, and last principal amount is 6,477. Okay, and then the same amount I'm writing here, 6,477, and let's deduct that. 20,456 minus 6,477. You get 13,979. So 13,979 is the answer what you get after 3 installments. Now there are 2 more to go. Okay. I don't have space, so I'll just rub this. Okay, I finish the third, then I'll write 4th installment. Is 7,500 minus interest on this value 13,979 at 5%. On this, I'll have to calculate 5%. I get 699. Okay, 699. I get 699. Minus 7,500, you get 6,801. So 6,801. Let me write the values. So total is 7,500 itself. Interest we have calculated 699, and the amount I have calculated 6,801. The same amount I'll be writing here, 6,801. For your understanding, I'll repeat this for the deduction. Okay. You get a 7,178. Okay. So we have finished 4 installments. The last installment is the 5th installment. Okay, 5th installment is 7,500 minus interest on this. At the last stage, you have to be very careful. I've written 7,500. Yeah, it is right. Sorry. 7,500. Okay. This is the last installment. So interest on 7,178. Okay. At 5%. But when you do the calculation for the 5th year, for example, I'll show you 7,178. If you're calculating 5%, you get 359. Okay, 359 answer you get, but unlike the like how we were doing for leasing problem, the balancing figure, the same we have to apply here. So 7,500 is the installment amount, but whatever is available for us, that principal amount we are going to write here in order to get the balancing figure as interest. So here we are not writing the interest amount. We are writing the principal amount. Okay. So let's deduct this 7,500 minus 7,178. You get 322. This is the interest, which is the balancing figure. We need not pay extra. So in order to do that, this is the balancing figure. And I'll write the amount here. And this is 7,500. Interest is 322. And this is 7,178. And this becomes nil. Okay. And we have to add all of these. How much do we get? So let's add all of these. So if I have written 7,500 5 times. Okay, then I have added 5,000 for that. So 7,500 into 5 plus 5,000. And this is 42,500. Okay, cash price, either if you want, you can calculate, or else they have already given in the problem 37,500. Okay, 37,500. Now, what you can do is either you can calculate all the interest, okay, or else you can write the balancing figure. What we'll do is I'll just erase this. I've kept that figure for the purpose of adding the interest. So first year the interest was 1,625. That was first year's interest, and second year it was, yeah, I can see here 1,331. Plus third year interest is 1,023. Plus fourth year it is 699. Plus 322. So 5,000 you are getting the interest total, and you can cross verify this by adding the principal amount and interest. You get the total amount. Okay, 37,500 plus 5,000, you get 42,500. So in this they have asked two questions: what is the principal and the interest? The interest is 5,000 and the principal is 42,500. Is this clear? Okay, so these are three problems which we have done pertaining to hire purchase, and in the next class we'll come up with a new topic. Thank you.